Hi there, my name is Kate Donovan and I am a healthcare consultant with Lawrence Associates. I am going to talk to you today about increasing access to prenatal care and a solution I have for that problem, which is, from the title you can see, midwives, mobile care units, and group prenatal visits. All right, our agenda today is to address some of the barriers in accessing high quality prenatal care. What are they? What can we do about that? What are the problems associated with that? And then I'm going to enlighten you as to a solution I have regarding that. So first of all, what are the barriers in access to prenatal care? Largely those barriers are transportation issues, women having a hard time getting to prenatal care, childcare issues, not having anyone to watch your children while you go to your healthcare appointment. And then lastly, feeling uncomfortable or unwelcome in the healthcare environment. And what can we do about that? Those barriers in and of themselves result in problems in pregnancy and birth, and those are increased maternal morbidity and mortality rates, increased infant mortality rates, and lastly, an increased financial impact of inadequate prenatal care. My solution, mobile care units staffed by midwives, going into communities that are underserved or have trouble accessing prenatal care. After I highlight that, we'll talk a little bit about our budget. I'll conclude and open the floor up for questions. So first off, our big problem here is maternal morbidity and mortality rates. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, death as a complication of pregnancy still ranks among the top 10 causes of death among women ages 15 to 34 in the US. These are largely preventable problems. Seeing women prenatally helps reduce morbidities by helping manage their chronic health problems. We also could provide prenatal education about pregnancy and birth that could enlighten them as to ways to maintain health, the health of themselves and their babies. Another ramification of inadequate prenatal care is infant mortality, tragic instances. And what we're finding is that there are big gaps in the access of prenatal care. And those gaps fall along, they're most common in racial and ethnic minorities, as well as low socioeconomic and educational status groups. And infant mortality rates, unfortunately, follow right along those gaps. So we're seeing non-Hispanic or African-American populations experience more than twice the rate of infant mortality compared to non-Hispanic white reference populations. Clearly a problem. Lastly, our big ramification of inadequate prenatal care is the cost of such a problem. All of us answer to a bottom line, especially those of us in healthcare. The cost of an uninsured birth or a birth with little or no prenatal care can truly be astronomical for, certainly for a citizen, but also for the facility. If a woman shows up for a birth without having any prenatal care, sometimes there are added interventions, and if she's unable to pay for any or all of that, oftentimes the facility will encumber the cost of that and help cover that. So it could be exponentially expensive. We also see compounding costs of interventions for preterm deliveries. We're seeing rising instances of preterm deliveries among women who don't have adequate prenatal care. And again, facilities can encumber those costs. This solution I'm setting forth seeks to save money before it's spent, essentially. And here we have a little statistic to support what I'm saying, that infants delivered after 37 weeks but before 39 weeks have significantly greater risks of mortalities and morbidities and account for an estimated $1 billion in increased hospital costs annually. And I'd like to point out that we're not even talking about extreme micropreemies, babies that are born close to viability dates at 25 weeks or greater. This is 37 to 39 weeks, so really maintaining and optimizing that pregnancy time is essential to health and financial health. The solution I have is mobile care units. We're talking about an RV, a good old-fashioned RV retrofitted to meet prenatal care needs. They'd be staffed by midwives who could conduct prenatal care, visits, and prenatal classes. And a vehicle like this could travel directly to the communities that need them the most. A key component to this solution, besides the RV, are the midwives. These are advanced practice nurses that provide high quality care that is cost effective and has proven excellent outcomes for both moms and babies. And they could offer group prenatal care. This is sort of a new concept and development that is, again, showing evidence of excellent success. It's very effective. It encourages and assures women attend because they find themselves accountable to each other and people in their own community. It empowers women in their own healthcare and spirit experience and that they are involved in their own care. They're doing their own weights as they come in. They're providing their own essential information, and we're kind of balancing out some of the power dynamics, making women feel more comfortable. And here we go with our budget. The cost of this project initially, this is the initial budget, starts with the RV, a 2015 basic model, Mirabus style, it's $100,000. The retrofitting involved in this project for prenatal care use involving late model medical care equipment would be about $60,000. Next up, we have salary and benefits for two midwives at $90,000 each. The second position here, the second midwife position, could be filled by a nurse practitioner who specializes in women's health. Next salary is the project manager, that's myself. And then we have another salary for the driver of the RV. We need someone well-trained in that, as well as somebody cross-trained as an EMT to help provide medical backup. And then lastly, we'll need supplies, such as laboratory items, prenatal class supplies, etc. That's about $10,000, bringing our total to $445,000. In conclusion, I think a project such as this, involving a mobile care unit staffed by midwives, will result in improved maternal and infant outcomes, eliminate barriers to care, and be cost effective. Are there any questions? Thank you.